الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول حي يا على الصلاة حي يا على الصلاة حي يا على الفلاح حي يا على الفلاح الله الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أرسل نبيه بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله فالله سبحانه وتعالى يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ويقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون فالتقوى مفتاح السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Quran is the word of God, it is the ultimate truth. We usually start by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking His forgiveness and seeking His guidance, and seeking refuge in Him from the evil of our deeds and the sins of our hearts. We bear witness that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sent His Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam with the message to guide the whole world as a mercy of all people. Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam fulfilled the message and fulfilled the trust and delivered the message as directed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bear witness that he is the last messenger of Allah, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send our prayers for him. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alameen innaka hamidun majeed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran to remain conscious of him and told us that being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantees happiness for us in this life and the hereafter. In this life, He promised to deliver us from each and every difficulty that we may face, and He will provide for us from whatever we did not expect. And in the hereafter, there are gardens under which rivers flow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the concept of forgiveness in the Quran in different ways. He praised those who forgive those who harm them or assault them or cause them difficulty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم والفواحش وإذا ما غضبوا هم يغفرون. And those who avoid committing major sins and immoral acts, and they forgive even when they are angry. This was a praise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people who, among His servants, who would forgive even though they were angry and they were seeking revenge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commends and praises those who الْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And those who control their anger and they pardon people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are muhsin, those who are doers of good. And then He promises those of us who would pardon and forbear great maghfirah from Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. They should pardon and they should forbear. Don't you like that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive you? And who among us who does not want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him or her for the things that he committed or the things that she committed? So these are three terms that are being used by the Quran to describe the concept of forgiveness. Al-Maghfira, which we translate as forgiveness, Al-Af, which we translate as pardon, and Al-Safh, which we translate as forbearance. And a safh or forbearance is the highest level of forgiveness. Because to forgive is to abstain from punishing the person who caused you harm or assaulted you. But to forbear, a safh, is not only to forgive or to forgo the punishment, but also to remove any bad feeling in your heart against that person. As if nothing has happened. You maintain the relationship as it used to be. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who forgive, pardon, and forbear, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them great reward. On the day of judgment, they will be called out and they will be rewarded for what they have done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are people who are able to take vengeance, people who are empowered to take revenge, but for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they forgo the punishment of the people who caused them harm, and they remove any bad feelings against them. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has established rules and laws for just retribution. When a person makes a wrong, commits a sin, or commits a wrong against somebody else, then there are rules for just retribution. And that's the law. That there is nothing against it. But a level above that, to reach the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to forgive, to pardon, and to forbear. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to become among those select people who would be able to do this. Because it is difficult. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recognizes that it is difficult to remove bad feelings, to abstain from taking revenge. This is, it needs to be worked at. People have cannot come, it doesn't come naturally. People have to work at it to be able to achieve it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to reach that level. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called himself Al-Ghaffar, the oft-forgiving, Al-Ghafoor, the all-forgiving, Al-Afu, the oft-pardoning. Three names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the 99 beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are dedicated to describe his ability to forgive and pardon his servants. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us to forgive and pardon us when we seek his forgiveness and we ask for his pardon. So that's how Islam looks at forgiveness. Let me move to give you an example, a life example from the life of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. How did he practice forgiveness? And to do that, let's go for the beginning of Islam in Mecca. Muslims were weak, they were persecuted, they were tortured, and some of them even were murdered. And when they migrated from Mecca to Medina, they lost their property, they lost their money, they lost even some of their family members who were prevented to migrate with them. And then a history of animosity between the pagans of Mecca and the Muslims living in Medina, wars one after the other. We all know the battles of Badr, the battle of Uhud, and the battle of the trench. These were battles where pagans fought Muslims to turn them away from their religion. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings victory to his servants. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam walks into Mecca on the head of a big army, a 10,000 people army, overwhelming power and force. And the people of Mecca, they didn't know what to do. The only thing, they surrendered. There were no violence, there were no war, there was surrender on their part. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam asked them, what do you think I would do with you? You know, remember all of what you have done to the Muslims and to me. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, they conspired to kill the Prophet, as we know, on the night that he migrated from Mecca to Medina. And in spite of all of this, the answer of the Prophet was, go, you are free. There was no punishment, there was no rebuke, and there was no blame. Complete safh from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to the people who for the last 8 years were, or maybe not only 8 years, maybe 20 years, were trying to force the Muslims to turn back from their religion. The Prophet Safh brought the people of Mecca into the fold of Islam. They realized how generous Islam is, how good Islam is, and most of them became Muslims. And that's the idea of making Safh and Af. In addition to obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive, forbear, and pardon. The other side issue is to bring people to change the hearts of people. Those who are feeling bad at you, they would turn around and they would love you. And that's the objective of Safah. There is another value for forgiveness that we can feel in this life. We know in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised those who forgive and forbear and pardon, promised them great rewards. He promised to forgive them. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you like that Allah would love, would forgive you? And as we saw, these would be muhsineen, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves al-muhsineen. And those who forgive are muttaqeen, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves al-muttaqeen. So you get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you get His forgiveness. But in this life, you get something else. You get happiness. For the last 30 years or so, scientists in the area of psychology and physiology were researching the effect of forgiveness on the human body. And they came to the conclusion that human body is affected by the forgiveness. When you forgive, there is a protein that is produced in the body which makes you feel happy. And that's scientific experiments. It's nothing, no claims in this. It has been proven scientifically and experimentally that this is true. They found out that people who are bent on vengeance, people who want to take revenge all the time, they suffer just like people who are subjected to stress continuously. And that produces chronic ailment in their body. So by forgiving, you don't lose your right, but you gain your happiness in this life and the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في هذا اليوم العظيم ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة.